डियर ऑल, वेलकम टू माई चैनल बायोलॉजी नोट्स। इन पैरासाइटिज्म पार्ट वन आई हैड ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट पैरासाइट्स। टूडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट होस्ट्स। कॉन्टेंट्स ऑफ द वीडियो इंक्लूड डेफिनेशंस ऑफ होस्ट, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ होस्ट विद एग्जाम्पल, होस्ट स्पेसिफिसिटी एंड हाइपर पैरासाइटिज्म। आई हैव मेन्शंड टू बेसिक डेफिनेशंस ऑफ होस्ट। नंबर ए, A host is an organism that harbors a parasitic, a mutualistic, or a commensalist guest, the guest typically being provided with nourishment and shelter. Number B, host is defined as an organism which harbors the parasite and provides nourishment and shelter. Now, I will discuss different types of host with example. Definitive host. This is a host in which a parasite reaches its sexual maturity. For examples, the Anopheles mosquito is the definitive host for the malarial parasite Plasmodium. Human beings are the definitive hosts of Schistosoma, etc. Sexual reproduction has not been clearly shown in some parasites, such as amoebas and most trypanosomes. And in these cases, we arbitrarily consider the definitive host, that one most important to humans. Intermediate host. This is a host in which some development of the parasite occurs, but the parasite does not reach sexual maturity. It often acts as a vector for the parasite to reach its definitive host. For examples, human beings are the intermediate hosts for the malarial parasite Plasmodium. Snails of the genus Bulinus are the intermediate host for the parasite Schistosoma, etc. Some parasites require two intermediate hosts to complete their different larval stages. These are known as the first and second intermediate hosts respectively. For example, amphibian snails are the first intermediate host and aquatic plants are the second intermediate host for Fasciola hepatica. Paratenic or transport host. In this host, the parasite does not undergo any development, but the parasite remains alive and infective to another host. Paratenic host may bridge an ecological gap between the intermediate and definitive host. The trematode Alaria americana may serve as an example. The mesosarcarial stages of this parasite reside in tadpoles. Tadpoles may be eaten by the definitive canine host, but this possibility is very rare. The tadpoles are more frequently preyed on by snakes. In snakes, the mesosarcary may not undergo further development. However, the parasites may accumulate in the snakes. So, the snakes serve as a paratenic host. Now, these snakes are usually consumed by canids. In this way, the canids, the definitive host, get infected with the parasite. Reservoir host. It is a host which harbors the parasites and serves as an important source of infection to other susceptible species. A single reservoir host may be reinfected several times. The host suffers no ill effects. For example, dogs are reservoir host of Leishmania, armadillos are the reservoir host of Trypanosoma cruzi, etc. Host specificity. Most parasites develop only in a restricted range of host species. That is, parasites exhibit varying degrees of host specificity, some infecting only a single host species, others infecting a number of related species, and a few being capable of infecting many host species. For example, the pork tapeworm Tinea solium apparently can mature only in humans. So, adult Tinea solium have absolute host specificity. The nematodes Trichinella sp seems to be able to mature in almost any mammals. Hyperparasitism. Many parasites host other parasites, a condition known as hyperparasitism. Examples are Plasmodium in mosquitoes, a tapeworm juvenile in a flea, a monogene on a copepod parasite of fish, and the many insects whose larvae parasitize other parasitic insect larvae. So this is all about basic concepts on host. If you have any query, please write in the comment section. Subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon to get notifications of new video. Like and share. Keep watching. Stay with us. Thank you.